What you doing down there?
She's like, don't mind me, I'm just hiding out from the kids and, you know, my new little storage compartment. On second thought, this might not be the most comfortable place. Welcome back, family travelers. We're so happy you're here. I'll continue this video once I get out of here, if I ever figure out a way.
I was filming the intro for this video and accidentally slammed the top down on Nick's head, and it was like pure silence. So I was like, you okay down there? Luckily, no one was harmed in the filming of this video.
Guys, we're back in the RV. It's been a while. It's been a long winter, but we've done some things and we're gonna tell you about them. 9 things that you can do to your RV right now that will just take this season to the next level. So come on, let's check it out. The first one we're gonna talk about, and I am not meant for this thing. It's 300 pounds, okay, I'm good. This is the first project we did for the camper, this ladder and this little like guardrail here to keep Olivia from falling out. And so she can actually get into bed. This is super easy to make. Just some 1x4 common board, some screws, a little bit of glue, and some stain. You just gotta cut everything to fit, clamp it together, and then measure it. Preferably you measure first, and that's it. Super easy.
Measure once.
Cut twice.
Measure twice, cut once. What is that back there?
That looks
for your
like
reading pleasure, buddy.
Appropriate. Math. Basic concepts.
Well, the snares work.
Great success. The next items, the next 2 items on our list, are the easiest by far of everything that we've done. And they're the ones that make the biggest impact. We'll show you like a before and an after, but I mean, look at this. It's so much brighter and nice. Subway tile. Real quick, all I did was go to Home Depot. I bought the tiles, I bought the grout, and then no, I'm kidding. They're peel and stick tiles. Come on now. Ordered them from Amazon. I'll put the link below. But honestly, it was a pretty easy project and you can't really tell if they're, you know, peel and stick. It's just a nice feeling. These peel and stick tiles, I didn't even know they were like were a thing before. Apparently all of the RV people that like renovate their kitchens use them. They're very, very simple to clean. Nice and glossy, so you're not gonna get a stain on them or anything. Peel and stick, that's it. That's all you gotta do. Beautiful. If you really wanna get the nitty gritty details on how to do this, we put it in a blog post. I'll link it down below so you can be bored to tears there instead of on video. The next improvement, come on down here. Look at this. Nice, shiny green. We painted it. I simplified it a lot, but really there's a little bit involved. We have to tape everything off so you're not getting paint everywhere. Hardware, see, you got some hardware here you gotta take off. Your camper might be different, but ours doesn't have a whole heck of a lot to do. But paint is one of those really, really underrated decorating tools. It really transforms the space. So we're happy with how this turned out. You could do yours like hot pink or lilac or a nice deep blue, whatever you want. The next one, this one doesn't make much of a visual impact at all. In fact, you're not even gonna see it and you probably have no idea what I'm talking about. But we boondock a lot. We use Harvest Host. And so we can't charge our phones on the electric system, but we installed a USB charger down here.
Hold on, I'm holding the camera with one hand.
Oh, get it together, woman. Look at this. Oh yeah, look at that. Really simple. Fun fact, you never put the USB in right the first time. It's always upside down. Just like that. So now we can charge our phones or the iPads even when we're boondocking. And I can sit right here and enjoy my brand new kitchen. So I'm happy.
There's not much space between here. Small RV problems.
That's why we bought a tiny RV.
You can make your coffee and
right?
Be on your phone.
It's perfect. I didn't really have much of a reason to move closer other than the fact that I really felt like I was shouting at you and I don't want to yell at you. So we're gonna move on to the next thing. This is my new napping spot, as you've seen. I can hide from the kids. No, so this was a wildly inconvenient storage space. Like we had to lift the mattress up to be able to put stuff in there. And that was a giant, giant pain because this mattress, while comfy, is very heavy. So we built a door. Rule 1 when you get a new camper is to always replace your mattress. And we love this one, but Like, this is how you have to get into. I can't even do it. You have to like tear it apart. See, that's how it used to work. But now, look at that. That's just so much easier. This one will absolutely make your life easier. It'll make your chiropractor mad. Most campers have this setup with the bed and the under mattress storage, which while great and saves on space, it is just, it's really inconvenient to get into. Of all of the builds that we did to the trailer, this one was by far the most complex. It wasn't terribly hard, but it was the most effort. So I had to take this whole bed out of the camper. Like literally I had all the walls out and everything. And then I used those measurements to build a new wall. This is all now like solid wood instead of like, you know, paneling. So it adds a little bit of weight, but it's a lot more structure to it. I have some pictures of the building process. We didn't like do a whole video on that, but I think it might be interesting to share. Well, Brittany tossed those up when she's editing the video. Not all of the changes are inside. Sometimes you gotta go outside. And we did this all in the winter, so like, I did some work in the cold, but come on, let's check it out. Look at that. This fix might just be the most exciting one of them all, and I'm totally lying through my teeth. This one's boring and you can't even tell, but that's a good thing. That'll hold. This thing on its own can hold 5,000 pounds and there is no moving it. And I put four of them on the camper. The ones that normally come with these kinds of campers, super chintzy, and all they do is stop the camper from tipping. But this one actually stabilizes and kind of lifts the trailer up a little bit. So this thing is not moving. This guy right here, this will make your life easier. This is a power jack. I'm not gonna demonstrate it because everything's all set up and square. I don't wanna break anything, but all I have to do is press a button and it goes up and down. I don't have to crank. I can have my setup beer in one hand and then lift and lower the camper in the other. Awesome. Best investment in camping, I think. Pretty close. And if you want to see it in action, we actually made a video about how the first one of them failed. It was the one that came with the camper and then it almost fell on top of me. But I don't want to talk about it anymore. This is the second to last one. It's not glamorous. It's not exciting. But boy, does it save you. It's a little switch that kills the battery. And by kills the battery, I mean disconnects it. So you don't actually burn power while it's sitting in your driveway. And why is that important? Because when you just let them sit, the batteries die and you ruin your battery. The other thing, for boondocking, it's great. If you leave your site, you can turn your battery off and things like the fire detector or the gas detector won't be draining batteries, which is, that helps keep the battery life a lot longer. This here, this is the last addition, the biggest addition, the most expensive one, but it's probably the one that's the most worth it. Come on, come on, get closer, get closer. Look at that.
Wait, some you gotta get the macro out.
Yeah, some nice Goodyear Endurance tires. Like, these are the cream of the crop for trailer tires. Anyway, the reason that we changed these tires is for a couple of reasons. One, we want to be able to get a little bit better fuel economy, have a little smoother ride, have a little bit less sway. We got bigger tires so they don't overheat quite as much and hopefully they'll keep their air and stay inflated a little bit longer. But the most important reason we got bigger tires, we're gonna be able to drive a lot faster, actually go the speed limit. Now you might be thinking to yourself, you could barely go 50 miles per hour on your last trip. Well, we made some other big changes, but more on that to come. That's that. 9 easy DIY tips to make your trailer more comfortable, usable, brighter, prettier, whatever. I got a little piece in my throat there. I don't know where that even came from. I don't know. Apparently there's like, it's starting to be spring. I digress. If you're anything like us, you're constantly trying to do different things. So we have a really tiny trailer and we're trying to make it just more like home. So we've got even more things coming. Hopefully we'll do some wallpaper like right here. This might be nice. A little bit of wallpaper there. Recover the cushions. You know, there's so many things we can do on a budget and a trailer like this. You know, if you have a big old trailer, you could just gut and do it whatever you want. But when you're limited on space, it becomes a little bit more challenging. So we're trying to have some fun with it. If you're curious about what the trailer looked like before we got our hands on it, go back a few videos and check out the tour that we did. We'll put a link to that one below. Now, we did some immediate changes that we talked about in there, but then we lived in this thing for a month and took a nice trip out west, and we really saw some things that we wanted to, you know, make better, make our lives easier, especially like the USB stuff. But anyway, that's something that we recommend you do. Use the trailer to live in it, and then take notes on improvements that you want to make. It'll really make your RVing life much, 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 much easier. We've got some exciting things coming up, at least we think so. We're about to go on another journey, and this time we're gonna show you how we prep for it, how we pack on it, pack for it. We're gonna show you how we pack for the trip. Last time we gave you kind of a really high level overview, but now we're gonna go in depth. Stay tuned for that. Plus, we're gonna show you our new tow vehicle. We're pretty jazzed about that. But for now, bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, do all that other good stuff. Until next time.